give him some praise.
Hallelujah.
Oh my God, oh my God. Oh my God, I come to magnify the Lord on tonight. Hallelujah. I come to bless him for this new dimension and new season and higher heights and deeper destinies carrying us. Not just me, but us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I come to give him a ridiculous wing. Season, hallelujah. So I welcome you now to Truth in the Word Deliverance Ministries, hallelujah. And I just want to give God some praise on tonight, hallelujah. We're going to get started with our service, hallelujah. Our prophetic exhorter is not here, hallelujah. So I'm going to do the best I can, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know I'll pass the mic in a minute, hallelujah. Bless your name, because it's not about me, but it's about God's people and the gifts being used in the body. Amen. Amen. So let's turn to our Bibles to Psalms 100. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. Oh my God, I just feel something in the atmosphere. Hallelujah. Coincidence that our weather today was almost 70 degrees. Hallelujah. I feel like this city and this crowd is going to shake. I feel awakened. Hallelujah in the spirit. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Who come to praise the Lord on tonight? Ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. you. Hallelujah. So we're going to go to the throne of grace. I know God has given us, I'm going to preach on Sunday, that God has gave us access granted. Hallelujah. He has gave us access. Oh my God. The portals are now open.
Receive, oh God, come and rain on us tonight, oh God. In a mighty way, oh God. For this is a revival. Revive us, oh Jesus. Our week is hard, oh God. Our week is hard, oh God. The month has been hard, oh God. Have your way in this place, Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, oh God, that your spirit is in this place, oh God, and that the blessings of Abraham rest and abide in this house, oh God. And we won't take it lightly, Jesus. For you are the God that made the universe. And we partake in you, oh God. We are a part of you and you and us, oh Father. So we thank you, we praise you, Jesus. We thank you for the blessings on tonight, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and we thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless your name, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Bless your name. Bless your name. Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. 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 Minister, I need you to come pray. Hallelujah. I need you to come pray. Hallelujah, 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 because hallelujah, we need to learn how to seek the face of God. Hallelujah, we need to learn how to make our petition to God. This is consecration month. Hallelujah, hallelujah, but some things don't come out but by fasting. Hallelujah, and prayer. Hallelujah, we must seek the face of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Son to the Lord God of the Saint, your name is to be praised, oh God. We thank you for allowing us to come to another year that wasn't promised to us, oh God. But you seem fit to bring us through, oh God, and allow us to bless your holy name, oh God. We thank you for this consecrated month and this revival right now, oh God. So somebody will be stirring up in this place right now, oh God. They will be renewed right now, oh God. They will be fed through your word right now, oh God. We bless your holy name, for you are God and God alone. We thank you for sitting high and looking low and keeping us through our valley experience, oh God. We thank you for your grace and mercy. We thank you for your everlasting love. We thank you for your long suffering, God, because you didn't have to save us, but you did, oh God. We was bound for hell, but you redeemed us, oh God. We thank you for your grace and mercy. We thank you for your love. We thank you for sending your son and being hung up for our hangups. We thank you, oh God, for taking on the sin for our life, oh God. Hallelujah. We thank you and just lift you up, for you alone are worthy to receive glory and honor, oh God. There is none like you. We bless your holy name, for you alone are worthy. We give you praise and honor and glory, oh God. We thank you for the people that are in this temple right now, oh God, who has a hunger for you, oh God. We just want to lift you up and just holler your name, oh God. For you are the Son, and we thank you that we do you. We are free indeed, oh God. We bless you, oh God. We thank you for being our propitiation, oh God. We thank you for being our intercessor, oh God. We thank you for being the one that took on our sins, oh God. We thank you, oh God. We thank you, we lift you up right now, oh God. You alone are worthy. We bless your holy name, oh God. We thank you for being a keeper when we didn't want to keep ourselves. We thank you, oh God. We thank you, oh God. We bless you, oh God. We magnify you, oh God. Hallelujah. 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 You are the people praise while you have the ability and the air. Desires of our heart to want to build and to build another uplifting of the kingdom, oh God. It is about kingdom building, oh God. We thank you right now, oh God. Hallelujah. It's not by power nor by might, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. We thank you right now, oh God. Hallelujah. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is true liberty. We thank you for freedom right now in this place, oh God. We bless your holy name, oh God. We thank you, oh God. But you are God and God alone. We love you, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen.
Yeah. prophetically exhort this scripture.
Say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You're going to have to activate that thing. Hallelujah. You start this. You start this. Amen.
Hey.
My God.
Thank you, Lord.
My God.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hallelujah.
And it's my word too. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Woo. Hallelujah.
Hey.
You see how the enemy listen. You know what?
Oh.
I'm going to tell you how I met him. I was supposed to have met him before I met him through him. But see, you know, sometimes people don't want you to connect because they know if you connect, it'll be a divine connection. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? But this is an awesome man of God. I know he plays instruments and things like that, but he can pray. Hallelujah. And I know he got some word in him. He can preach. Hallelujah. And he has a high calling. A very high calling. Hallelujah. I know him by the Spirit now, by the Spirit, as a humble man of God. Hallelujah. Yes, yes, he is. Hallelujah. So he's going to, and I know he got the word down in him. Hallelujah. Our foundational scripture for this revival is Isaiah 60:1. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on, you can take the food in. You all right? Amen. You can use my Bible. You see that? Amen. Amen. And then when he finished, we could probably open up a testimony, but if it's flowing, it'll be right in the hands of Apostle Pruitt. Hallelujah. To come with the word. Hallelujah. And after that, we're going to take up our offering and we're going to see what else God has, and we're going to go home. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes,
glory, yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah. That's what I'm talking about. That's freedom right there. There is victory in Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to go ahead and read this scripture, Isaiah 61. I'm sorry, 60:1.
Hallelujah.
And it reads as thus: Arise and shine, for the light is coming, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon thee. Hallelujah, hallelujah. How many know that God is the light of the world? Hallelujah. How many know that he is the light of the world? I don't sound like you know it. I ain't in no funeral home. You better act like you know that he is the light of the world. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You just begin to think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for you. And your soul will begin to cry out and say, oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 See, I don't know about what you know, but I know Jesus was the only one that got up. Hallelujah. Buddha is dead. Confucius is dead. Krishna is dead. But Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You better act like you know. Because see, I'll stand here until you get it. I'll stand here until you get it. You better know that there's freedom in Jesus. Victory in Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We was once bound, but now we're free. Hallelujah. The Bible says who the Son sets free is free indeed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Y'all better have some Bible readers. Hallelujah. I ain't with that Bible. My pastor said Bible. I don't like that Bible. You better know what the Word says. My hope is built on nothing less but Jesus' blood and his righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but the holy land on Jesus' name. On Christ, the solid rock, I stand.
PSA, you a preacher of the gospel, you got to be ready when you come up in here. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You never know when I might pass the mic. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. But let me just go ahead and give a little bit, and I thank you so much. Give a man of God a hand praise. Hallelujah. I just threw that on him, but he accepted graciously. Hallelujah. You have to be ready in season and out of season. Hallelujah. The word for the weary. Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God. Woo. The word of God said, arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people, but the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee, and the Gentiles shall come to thy light, and kings to the brightness of thy rising. Hallelujah. This is the rising of, arising of his glory, 2012. Hallelujah. And the Lord had been dealing with me with this thing. Hallelujah. I'm going to get up and get right back down. Hallelujah. But he's been dealing with me, been arising in his glory. And that tells me that, we have to come up. Hallelujah. Arise means come up. Arise means get up. Arise means get up. Hallelujah. We have to get up in our thinking. We have to get up in our way that we, in our manner of conversation. We have to get up in our giving. We have to get up in our serving. We have to get up. Hallelujah. We have to arise. Hallelujah. Rise to the occasion of the service of the Lord. Hallelujah. When we get the mindset to arise, ain't nothing will be able to pull us back. There's nothing be able to pull us back and back to where darkness was. When we arise, hallelujah. Arise in your spirit. Get up in your spirit. Hallelujah. Don't let the enemy beat you down. But rise up with some praise. Rise up with some worship. Rise up and give him glory. Hallelujah. The Bible says, when you arise, hallelujah, then the glory will come. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. When you arise, the glory will come. And hallelujah, the glory of God, God, then will see your goodness and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Yes, when we arise in his glory, when we arise and come up so much in his glory, hallelujah, what the naysayers say won't even bother us. They'll bounce, but come to us, but it'll bounce back out to us. Hallelujah, we'll be shining in him. He said, even though the earth may be dark, but oh God, he is raising up a remnant of people that will be, spectrums of light in the dark world. He's raising up a remnant of people who will give him praise, honor, and glory at any time. That's not afraid of the gospel. Huh? That's not afraid of the gospel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen. The word of God says upon thee. Hallelujah. And his glory shall, you will be a glory possessor. You will be a glory carrier. You will be one that will come walk into a place and shift the atmosphere. You will be the one, hallelujah, that can speak a word of deliverance when you possess and carry the glory. And when you arise in his glory. I'm about to pass it over, brother. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Gentiles, the unbelievers, then, oh my God, I was first called evangelist. Then the unbelievers will see the light. Hallelujah. Then the unbelievers, the Gentiles, hallelujah, will be able to come and see the salvation of the Lord. Yes. When your light so shine before men, when your light so shine, when the glory of the Lord is so much upon you, hallelujah, when you can walk into a bank. When you can walk into a bank, hallelujah, and you know that your credit score is -200, and they say, well, you know what? I see on this paper that it's -200, but your integrity and your character, the glory of the Lord will tell you that it's approved. When you'll be able to walk into a hospital, and the glory of the world, the Lord will raise people out of their sick beds. Hallelujah, but I can't preach. Amen. I can't preach. Hallelujah. But I want to give way for the man of God, because I want to keep you all night, and I know that he moves prophetically in deliverance. Hallelujah. And I want to give space for him. So if you could just stand to your feet. Hallelujah. I'm feeling this arising in his glory. Hallelujah. We have to arise. We something. We have to shift. Hallelujah. We were talking about, you know, at work, a lady said that she's shifting. And then I said, well, what does that mean to you? She said that she's going to stay until something happens. I said, no, what you're in is neutral. Oh, my God. What you're in is neutral. You cannot shift and be in the same state that you have. What you are is in neutral. That means, that tells me that you're stagnant, that you stink.
Yeah. Come on.
Well,
come on.
Because when you shift it with the Lord, I know that it's the song, when I move, you move just like that, just like that. Hallelujah, just like that. When you shift it with God, it's just like that. It's just like that. When He moves, you move. Responsive obedience. That's shifting.
Yeah.
So on my last day, she was kind of mad at me because I told her that she wasn't shifting.
That's all right.
She was in neutral. And I said, but I'm shifting.
All right.
Hallelujah. I'm not going to sit here and die.
All right.
Hallelujah. I'm moving with God. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Why sit there and die when God's telling you to move?
Yeah.
Why sit there and die when God's telling you to shift?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Why sit there and die? Hallelujah. When God told you to move.
Yes.
I don't know who that's for.
Hallelujah.
But there you go. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Let's receive the man of God at this time, the prophet Brian Pruitt. We give honor to his lovely wife, Prophet Shanika Pruitt from New England International. Hallelujah. This is my brother in the Lord. Hallelujah. This is their 5th year anniversary of their ministry. Hallelujah.
Bless
your name, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Lord, give Jesus a high praise.
Hallelujah.
Now, I must tell you once again, the Holy Spirit got ahead of me once again and displayed the message. Let me use that right there. Already displayed the message before I got up here. Now, see, some of y'all got religious when she said, when I move, you move just like that. But let me tell you, that's prophetically what God is saying. He said, when I move, you move just like that.
Okay, come on now.
See, I just want to be released tonight to flow in something like I've never flown in before.
All right.
Because the message has been preached. The word that I had is exactly what the theme of this whole thing. But let me just throw this at you. You're going to sit down for a minute. I don't want your legs to get all tired because you're going to be moving tonight. Just like that.
Yes, God.
Genesis chapter 1. That's not my message, but I just want to drop something on you, okay? I just want to drop this word on you. Genesis chapter 1. New Year's Day. I got up at work. I was walking. Felt like something was missing. Something's not right, God. Although we're in the new year. And so I'm walking down the hall of my job, and I said, God, what is this? What am I feeling right now? I don't understand. And so as I'm walking and praying and walking, the Lord said this to me very, very clearly. He said, my people went into 12 soberly. My people went in praying in a tone of, I hope this will be a good year. So, prayer time entering to 2012 was a, oh God, we just pray that this happens, and oh God, that we just pray that this is in place, and oh God, we just pray that, you know, that you just really move this year, and God, you know, the devil's busy, and all that. There was a lot of promoting of what the enemy was doing. And so God says, my people went into the year like that. So he said to me, he says that I have ordered a divine reversal.
All right.
He says, I'm giving you another chance to enter into the year the right way.
All right.
And he said, this year, you have been called to enter into this year with celebration.
Yes, God.
Yeah.
Keep your finger on Genesis chapter 1. But Acts 12, you don't have to turn there. Many of you know it. It was a story where Peter was in prison.
Yes, God.
And the Bible said that the church were praying for Peter.
Yes, God. My God.
So while they were praying, Peter locked up now. And Peter was in some trouble here because, let me just give it to you, just a hood black folk version, that Peter was about to get done in.
Yeah.
And so he was in the prison now, and they were praying. And while they were praying, the Bible said now that this cell, this jail that Peter was in, it was locked up. It was securely guarded. And so Peter couldn't get out, nobody could get in. And so while the church was praying, the Bible said that the angel of the Lord showed up and opened up the cell that was locked by man.
Uh-huh.
Peter couldn't get out, nobody could get in. But the angel opened up this cell, and so Peter now, sleepy now, the angel goes over and pushes him and nudges him and says, hey, get up.
Come on.
Get your coat on. Uh-huh. Let's go. Now the Bible said that Peter didn't know if it was a vision or if it was real. He had no idea, but he just heard the angel say, come on, follow me. And they walked out of the cell and walked past these guards.
Uh-huh.
Watch it now. Now, Peter is free. And so the Bible said he came to himself and he was like, okay, man, you know, this thing was real. Now, let's go back to the people that were praying, the church that was praying. And so now, watch this now. The church is praying and Peter knocked on the door. And the only one that heard the sound of the knock was a girl named Rhoda. Bible said that Rhoda went to the door, heard Peter's voice, opened the door, so startled, so excited, she slammed the door, was like, oh my gosh.
Yeah,
and she ran back
to
go tell the people, hey, Peter's at the door.
Uh-huh.
Watch this now, I got a question. Why is it that Rhoda was the only one that heard the knock?
Come on now.
Because we have become so familiar in prayer and in our fasting, let me just tell you this. You can take a good thing and make it familiar and make it bad.
Yes, God.
Just because it's the new year, just because it's New Year's Eve, if God hasn't told you to pray, why are you doing it?
Come on.
My God.
If God hasn't told you to fast, why are you doing it? So my issue is here is they were praying, but nobody could hear the knock. Which is a picture now of nobody was in a place of expectation.
Yes, God.
So now we're just praying, but expecting nothing.
My God.
Watch it.
Well, knocking at the door. One girl hears the knock. A generation. Here's the knock. That's the reason why you need to stop hitting and beating and coming down on your youth every time they're trying to bring something new. They're trying to, you know, do something new for the kingdom. They're trying to, you know, bring some rap in and they're trying to exercise their gift, but you keep putting your thumb on them. God says, leave them alone because they hear the sound. They hear a knock. And so she heard the knock. And so watch this now. She goes back to the prayer meeting. Goes back to the church that's operating in the familiar and say, hey, what you've been praying for is at the door. Okay, you're going to get about 2 minutes. What you've been praying for is at the door. No. Get up off your knees. Get off the floor. Stop.
Come on.
So they like, oh, she just saw a ghost. And see, this is where we've been. See, this is where we're on New Year's Eve. We were becoming familiar.
My God.
See, this is what we did in the past. This is what our forefathers did. This is what we do every year. This is what we do on watch night. We come together and we pray. We come together and we fast. And the answer is at the door. God says, you don't need to pray. You don't need to fast. He said, why? He said, because your answer is at the door.
Yeah.
He says, if you would just get up off your knees and go to the door.
Oh, God.
See, I'm your rotor tonight. I'm trying to get you up to let you know that, hey, you can cease now because your answer is at the door.
Hallelujah.
So that's why God says, He says, I want you to come into 2012 now with celebration and rejoicing because your prayer and your time with me has touched heaven.
Yes, God.
And while you were praying, the angel of the Lord was unlocking things.
Glory to God.
Woo. While you were praying, the sails were open. I'm talking about man-made stuff. I'm talking about what man said that I will never unlock this. I will keep this locked. I will keep this shut. You will never get it here. The angel of the Lord went and opened it up and got your answer out. Now, I heard it declare tonight that the answer is unlocked.
Hallelujah.
The door is unlocked. So now the Lord started speaking to me again. And he gave me this, and I'm laying in my bed before tonight, early tonight, just trying to get some rest in. And I heard this while I had some worship music going on. Genesis chapter 1. The Lord said to me, in the beginning, God prepared, formed, fashioned, and created the heavens and the earth. Now that's just the Amplified version. Let me give you the New King James version. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. I want us to focus on that word created, because I want to declare to you, which is simply announcing, then I'm gonna shift over to decreeing, which means ordering, that there are gonna be creative miracles tonight. Yeah. And so I just want to show you the scripture to back it up. In the beginning, oh, watch this, follow me prophetically. In the beginning, this is the first month of the year, so we're in the beginning. Yeah. In the beginning, the first fruit, the first, the best part, that's what that word in the Hebrew means, the best part, God created, he formed, he fashioned, he began to work and create a miracle in the beginning. In the beginning. So let me just say to you right now that the Lord said the next 7 days, watch this now, the next 7 days is going to be creative miracles.
Yes,
and if you read the first chapter of Genesis, God began to create something out of nothing. He began to create something out of chaos. And God says that these next 7 days, I'm going to begin to prepare and to build now what is going to bring forth the miracle perpetually. Picture this. Before a house is built, or before a house is filled with people, you must dig the ground.
Yes, God.
You must build a frame. You must
get all
the foundation together. You gotta put up the drywall. You gotta, you gotta get the screws and nails, like put on the roof, and then you gotta go out there and you gotta make sure that, you know, if it's a brick house, you know, you gotta make sure the bricks upright and all that stuff. And all this, what are they doing? They're preparing now for somebody to occupy that space.
Yeah.
I want you to hear me prophetically tonight, because the next 7 days are going to be creative miracles of God preparing for for you to occupy, preparing for you. I want you to see what God was doing in that first chapter. He began to make the sky and call it day and call it night. And he began to divide the waters. Why? Because he was preparing for a nation. He was preparing for a people, a family. And so God says, these next 7 days, I'm creating miracles.
All right.
That are going to begin. They're going to begin. But it's not just going to last the 7 days and then stop. Mm-hmm. It is something that I am starting, says God, that is going to pour into you for the rest of the year. Okay. So God says again to you, in the beginning, I create. I created. In the beginning, in this first month, in this first month of the year, you're going to begin to see things created.
All right.
Uh-huh. So I think that we just need to worship him as creator.
Yeah.
We worship him as Lord. We worship him as King. We worship him as Savior. But we don't worship him as creator. Do you realize that what happened tonight earlier, that God was beginning to do a thing in this place? Your praise releases creative miracles. This is what I saw tonight for the service. As we were just praising God and releasing a joy and just celebrating in this house, I saw creative miracles beginning. I saw body parts. I asked God to unload his storeroom of body parts in this place. God is going to do some things creative in this house tonight.